Old school music that we love. Rick Price has been a staple of the Aussie music landscape for three decades, first bursting onto the scene with hyper ballads like these. Not a day goes by.
Voice of a supreme angel, David, the greatest. Rick is now taking his 10th studio album, Soulville, on tour around the country. And we are delighted to say he joins us now in studio. Rick,
hey, buddy, good to see you.
Hi, guys. That beautiful compliments. Thank you so much.
Well, we're sitting here singing along, humming along to your
iconic
ballads.
That you knew the melodies of those songs.
Why on earth would you be surprised?
Well, you're too young to
remember.
Oh,
no.
You started already.
You know that old thing.
Your music lives on and on and on, and they're just classics. I'm surprised that you're surprised that we would know them.
Well, I'm just glad I showed up this morning.
Back to surprise, surprise with Rick.
I love your suit too.
Oh, thank you.
Look at these two Queenslanders. They're bad that they're both from Queensland.
Oh, we go back.
And they hit it off.
We stick together, don't you know?
Tell us about Soulville.
Soulville is a collection of all my favourite soul classics from the 1960s. And it's an album I've just always wanted to make. I grew up listening to that music, loved it, was influenced by those singers. And, you know, I saw an opportunity to make the album and took it. So
you did this in Nashville, right? So you live in Nashville, you're based there. So you'd have all those great musos around there that some of them might have even played on some of these records. Did anything like that happen?
No, as a matter of fact, I played everything.
Wow.
I'm very selfish in that way. No, I played all the instruments myself except for, you know, horns, strings, and some Hammond organ. But I played pretty much played the rest of it.
My gosh.
And there's some Aretha Franklin, Dionne Warwick in the mix. Talk us through the tracks.
Yeah, well, it's all my favourite songs, and I basically just picked my favourite artists and then picked my favourite songs. Mm-hmm. And yeah, Sam Cooke, you know, Otis Redding, Aretha Franklin, of course. I even picked an old obscure Stevie Wonder song.
Which one?
Until You Come Back to Me, which he wrote in the 60s. So that was my criteria.
Not Till You Come Back to Me, it was another one.
Until You Come Back to Me.
That's What I'm Gonna Do, that one?
No. Yeah.
Really?
That's I'm gonna
Did he write that?
He wrote that.
I did not know that, Rick.
Yes, I know. And a lot of people don't know that.
That one.
That's right.
There you go.
I had no idea.
Yeah. And he wrote it in the 60s, didn't put it out, and then gave it to Aretha Franklin, I think, in 1973. And she had the hit with it.
Yeah, that's right. I've heard her sing that song. And you've done a tribute to Aretha on this, because you wrote a song for her.
Yes, we did. I wrote a song with my friend John Capek, who is an Australian who also lives in Nashville. We had this piece of music that was gospel, rhythm and blues. I could hear a choir in it, and we had the melody, and because John's a beautiful gospel piano player and writer. So we had this piece of music sitting around for a while. So once the Soulville album came into existence, I thought, gee, wouldn't it be beautiful to add this song? And John sent me the lyric, basically, for the song. He had written it overnight, just sent it to me the next morning as a tribute to Aretha, and I thought, well, this is perfect. Yeah. So that's how the song ended up. And, you know, she was a great influence on me as a kid and so many singers. You can hear a little bit of Aretha in everybody.
She's the blueprint of soul, absolutely.
And what are you most looking forward to about being on stage with this album?
With this tour?
Mm.
Well, first of all, just being back in the seat again, like being back with a live audience, because, like as you know, David, there's nothing like that experience. And I've been really happy working in my studio, but I can't wait to get back to that sort of exchange with the audience. So that, and just singing these songs, the songs that I've loved since I was a kid, and sharing them with the audience and hearing them sing them. So I'm kind of looking forward to like a bit of a good time party tour with these with this
certainly album. Sounds like it's going to be that. But, yeah. You know, as you say, you did all the recording of this. You're sort of a master craftsman. You write songs.
Yes, David, you're absolutely.
You are. and your cobbling is great for you too. But you're doing this masterclass stuff online too. Where you're sort of educating people about it. What can people get out of that working with you? Because I think that's really, really important to reach down to the next generation.
It's a beautiful thing to pass it on. It happened by accident, really. I was invited to give some talks about songwriting at various different music colleges around the place, and I found that I really enjoyed it, and I really got engaged with the classes and people asking questions. And the more you dig into to your own process, the more you start to understand it. So I think what I hope to do for young people starting off is to help them cut some corners, mm-hmm. to point them in, you know. Because as creators, we're wandering around bumping into walls, you know. Yeah. So, hopefully to give some shortcuts and some insights into what, to help them find their own process. Because it's not about me teaching them my process. Mm. It's more about, you know, find your own inner mastery, because it's there if you give yourself permission to do it.
So good.
That's very generous of you to share your experience with so many
others. I get
so
much out of it, so it's, you know. It goes both ways.
Well, congrats on the new album and good luck on tour. Enjoy.
Great
enjoy
to see
being
you,
out.
Thank
out
you.
And about.
Rick
lovely
Price is going to be touring the country from this Friday.
Australia.
You can get the tickets to his shows at rickprice.com and go get the album too. Good to see you.
See you soon.
Thank you.
Travel
guys.
Well.
Still ahead, an urgent plea from the Posties.